Welcome to a second lesson on simplifying radical expressions. In this lesson, we'll simplify radical expressions with fractions. A radical expression is said to be in simplest form if all of the following three statements are true. Number one, all possible nth powered factors have been removed from each radical, and this was the main focus of our first lesson. Number two, no radical contains a fraction. Number three, no denominator of a fraction contains a radical. If the denominator does contain a radical, we'll multiply the numerator and denominator by a radical that makes the denominator a perfect nth root, meaning it will simplify perfectly, and this process is called rationalizing the denominator. Let's take a look at our first example. Here we have the square root of 4/9. This is not in simplest form because we have a fraction under the square root. So for the first step, we're going to take advantage of this property here that says if we have the square root of a fraction, it's equal to the square root of the numerator divided by the square root of the denominator, which means the square root of 4/9 is equal to the square root of 4 divided by the square root of 9. Now this is not in simplest form because now the denominator contains a radical. But notice how both 4 and 9 are perfect squares, so this simplifies perfectly. And the reason it does is because 4 is a perfect square, since we can write 4 as 2 times 2. And 9 is also a perfect square because we can write 9 as 3 times 3. So because these are square roots, meaning the index is 2, and both square roots have 2 equal factors, this simplifies perfectly. The square root of 4, or the square root of 2 times 2, is equal to 2. And the square root of 9, or the square root of 3 times 3, is equal to 3. So now the radical is simplified. But they won't all be this straightforward. Let's take a look at a second example. Here we have the square root of 9/11. And again, the first step is to break this up into the square root of the numerator and the square root of the denominator. So we have the square root of 9/11, which is equal to the square root of 9 divided by the square root of 11. Now, even though the numerator does simplify perfectly, we want to focus on the denominator because this is not in simplest form because we have a square root in the denominator. So if we want the denominator to simplify perfectly, notice how we'd have to have two factors of 11 underneath the square root in the denominator. And this is why we're going to multiply both the numerator and denominator by square root of 11. So now when we find this product, the numerator is going to be the square root of, well, 9 is equal to 3 times 3, and 11 is prime, so we have the square root of 3 times 3 times 11. And now in the denominator, we would have the square root of 11 times 11. Notice how now we have a perfect square underneath the square root in the denominator, which will simplify perfectly. So now we'll simplify this. Looking at the denominator, this will simplify. Looking at the numerator, this will simplify. So in simplified form, this will be equal to 3 square root of 11 divided by 11. This is considered the simplified form of square root 9/11. It doesn't really look any more simplified, but the main thing we should notice is that the denominator does not contain a radical, and there's no fraction underneath a radical. Now let's take a look at the cube root of 2/3. Again, this is not considered simplified because we have a fraction under the radical. So the first step, we're going to write this as the cube root of 2 divided by the cube root of 3. Now this is not considered simplified because we have a radical in the denominator. Now we want to focus on what it's going to take to make the denominator simplify perfectly. Well, now because we have a cube root, if we had 3 factors of 3, this would simplify perfectly, which means we're going to multiply both the numerator and denominator by the cube root of 3 times 3. Notice in our denominator we would now have 3 factors of 3, and since we have a cube root, it's going to simplify perfectly. But of course we have to do the same to the numerator. So we'll have the cube root of 3 times 3. Now let's go ahead and multiply. Looking at the numerator, we would now have the cube root of 2 times 3 times 3. And the denominator would now be the cube root of 3 times 3 times 3. And again, because we have a cube root, we're looking for groups of 3 equal factors, which would be perfect cubes, which we have here. Notice in the numerator, we don't have 3 equal factors, so the numerator would not simplify. So the simplified form, we would have the cube root of 2 times 3 times 3, that's going to be 18. And the denominator simplifies perfectly to 3. Again, it doesn't look any more simplified, but by definition, this is the simplified form of cube root 2/3. Now let's take a look at two more examples that contain variables. Here we have the square root of 2 divided by 5x squared y the third. First step is to write this as the square root of 2 divided by the square root of 5. I'm going to write x squared as x times x. I'm going to write y to the third as y times y times y. And again, our goal here is to make the denominator simplify perfectly, meaning we want groups of 2 equal factors for every existing factor in the denominator. So to make the denominator simplify perfectly, notice how we only have one factor of 5. We'd have to have 2 to make it simplify perfectly. So we're going to multiply by the square root of one factor of 5. Notice how we already have two factors of x, that'll simplify perfectly. We already have two factors of y, but to make this simplify perfectly, notice how we need one more factor of y, so we're going to multiply by the square root of 5y. And then we'll do the same to the numerator, so we have the square root of 5y here. And now let's multiply. In the numerator we have the square root of 2 times 5 times y. Our denominator will now be the square root of 5 times 5. We still have two factors of x. And now we have 1, 2, 3, 4 factors of y. And again, because we have a square root, meaning the index is 2, we'll make groups of 2 for the equal factors. So here we have two factors of 5, two factors of x, two factors of y, and two factors of y. And again, the key here is noticing the denominator is going to simplify perfectly. Notice the numerator is not going to simplify, so we'll have the square root of 10y divided by, our denominator is now going to be 5, one factor of x, and two factors of y, one from each group, so we'd have y squared. There's one more thing to mention about this example. Remember in the previous video we said when simplifying radicals with variables, if the index is even and the simplified variable has an odd exponent, like here we have x to the first, we do need to include that variable part in an absolute value to assure the result is positive. So let's go ahead and write this as the square root of 10y. We can put just the x in the absolute value or the entire denominator. Let's go and just put the x this time. So we have 5 absolute value of x, y squared. Now if we were told the variables were always positive, we would not have to include the absolute value. And again, it only comes into play when the index is even and the simplified variable has an odd exponent. Let's look at one more. Here we have the cube root of 5 divided by 4x squared y. First step, write it as the cube root of 5 divided by the cube root. I'm going to write 4 is 2 times 2, two factors of x, and one factor of y. Again, focusing on the denominator, which we want to simplify perfectly, we would have to have groups of 3 equal factors now because the index is 3. So looking at the denominator, notice how we have two factors of 2, but we need 3 to make it simplify perfectly. So we're going to multiply by the cube root of 2 We have two factors of x, we need one more x. And we only have one factor of y, we need two more factors of y. Notice now we have three of each factor. We'll do the same to the numerator. Now we'll multiply. In the numerator we have 2 times 5 times x times y times y. Notice nothing's going to simplify. But in the denominator, we now have 3 factors of 2, 3 factors of x, and 3 factors of y. Which is perfect because the index is 3. Here's a perfect cube factor, as well as here and here. Now in simplified form, we'd have the cube root of 10xy squared divided by, we'd have 2xy. And we never have to worry about the absolute value if the index is odd. I hope you found these examples helpful.